welcome back. It's your girl Katie here, and today I have my July Boxycharm base box here. So this is the base box, which is $25 a month. So as usual, I'm going to be doing an unboxing of it, and then after that I will be doing a trying on of everything that's in the box. So yeah, let's just go ahead and get into the unboxing. So they did finally send me a card in one of my boxes. I think it's been a while since I've gotten one in my base box, but here is the card. So the theme is sunshine. It's a very summer looking card here. Reminds me of summer with the little limes or lemons, whatever those are. They're limes and lemons. It's a very cute card. So I got variation 70. Now this is just a personal thought, but I feel like there is just way too many variations, considering I got number 70, variation number 70. It's quite a bit. All right, so the first thing I am seeing in here is our skincare product. I mean, it seems like it's pretty common now for you to get at least one skincare product in every box now. It didn't used to be like that. It used to be that skincare was kind of a not common thing, but now it just seems like they always have skincare now. So this is by Clean Skin Club, and it is a vitamin C brightening and booster. And this retails for $49.95. So it does feel like a very nice, you know, serum, and the bottle's very pretty. It's like this blue, kind of like frosty look to it. It looks very nice, and I'll try it out. I've never heard of this brand, the Clean Skin Club. I've never heard of it, so I'm excited to try it out. So this will be one product that I'm not going to be trying out today. So next up by Lavish is the Quick Color Switch Dry Brush Cleaner. So it's just this little tin, and then inside the tin, it just has this little foam thingy in here that you clean your brushes on. So if you're doing a makeup look that you need to use the same brush, but kind of, you don't want to go get it wet and clean it, you can just brush it on here to get the eyeshadow off of it. At least that's what it says. I've never tried one of these, and I have been wanting one of these, so this is nice to get. So yeah, I'm excited to try this out. Alright, and this supposedly retails for $20. I think that's a little much, considering, honestly guys, it is just literally a can, like a little container with just this foam. I don't know if this foamy stuff is special, but I mean, it doesn't look special, so I think that's a bit overpriced, but that's just my personal opinion. Alright, three more products. So next up is something by Hourglass, which I'm excited to get. Seems like they have been putting more Hourglass in the boxes lately. So this is the Arch Brow Micro Sculpting Pencil. And I got it in the shade Warm Brunette. The packaging is very nice. So it's kind of got like a teardrop shape to it. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. It's so tiny. It's not a pencil, but it's like rounder. But it's not a triangle. I'd say it's like a teardrop. And then of course on the other end is the spoolie. Now I went ahead and used this today because I just tweezered and trimmed my brow. So they were very thin. So I went ahead and used this just because it looked really funny with no eyeshadow or anything on, and then my eyebrows are just basically non-existent. So I did go ahead and put it on, and I did like it. I mean, I think I prefer pencil shapes over the circular kind of like teardrop. I mean, it wasn't bad, and it's very small, so I can make it work. I mean, I think the color is fine for me too. This retails for $28, which I think is pretty pricey for an eyebrow pencil. But again, that's just a personal opinion. All right, two more products. So next up is the palette. We usually always get a palette as well, whether it be a face palette or an eyeshadow palette. But this one is from Pure, and this is the Festival palette. And this retails for $36. So the packaging is really cool. I have to say that I'm not really impressed with getting another Pure palette. We get lots of Pure palettes, at least I do. It seems like I always get the ones by Pure. And they're honestly not one of my favorite brands. I just don't think the quality is the best. But I haven't tried this palette out, so maybe their quality or their formula has gotten better. It's just the ones that I've always gotten, they're not the greatest. So the packaging is really cool. And then it does have a mirror, and then here are the shades. I mean, I'm just not impressed, really. I mean, they look okay, and I'll try it out. It's just, this palette just doesn't really excite me. It just looks like another palette, honestly. I feel like I've seen these shades many, many times, and it's just nothing new. But again, maybe I'm just being a bit negative. I'll try it out. Hopefully it's good. Maybe I'll love it. I don't know. So there's that one. So I said that one retails for $36. And then last but not least is a product from Hank and Henry. We have gotten this brand several times too, and I do like this brand. And this is the Satin Matte Lipstick in the shade. What shade are you in? I'll have to open it up first, but here is the box. It's very cool, red, kind of sleek packaging here. Now this one retails for $17, and the shade that I got is Sext, S-E-X-T. Packaging is very pretty, it's very sparkly. Now I think this is the one where you have to like push the top, so you push the top and it pops out the bottom. And it's sparkly. You guys see that? It's really cool looking. Never had a lipstick that has sparkles on it. I'm gonna go ahead and swatch it. It looks like a brown. Can't say that this is my favorite shade, but at least it's not a pink, so I'm happy about that. I don't mind browns. I mean, it's more of a fall color, I think. I wouldn't say it's a summer color, but I'll be trying it out. I'm kind of interested to see what the sparkles do, like, do they add to it? So it's just on the outer part, so I feel like you don't really get the sparkles. It's just more about, you know, it's just the brown color. It's just like kind of, I mean, I guess I kind of see some sparkles. It'll just be like a little bit. But it does kind of feel a little dry on my hand, like it's kind of tugging, so we'll see how it applies. Alright, so that is everything in the box. I'm going to go ahead and tally up everything to see what the overall value of the box is, and then we will move on to the trying on part. Alright, so the overall value for my box is $150.95, which is pretty good considering, you know, I only paid $25 for it. So yeah, I think the value is pretty good this month. It's a lot better than I think maybe a couple of months ago. I don't know. They've had some bad months, but they seem to be getting back on track and getting better. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the trying on part now. All right, so we only have about two products that I can try out. I mean, I'll try the color switch thing, but that's not really something that I'll be trying on my face. Like I said, I already did my brows just because I didn't want to scare you guys with my non-existent brows at the moment. I never try out skincare on camera. I mean, I can update you guys as I try it out, but that's something that I don't go through. Skincare is not something that I go through really fast, so it takes me a while. So by the time I finish the products, I've probably gotten about 10 items in my boxes. You know, it takes me a while, so I feel like it's harder for me to update you guys on skincare, but I can if that's what you guys want. Alright, so I'm just going to go ahead and start with the palette. That's really, I mean, they didn't really send me much to try on. They didn't send blush or anything this time, so I'm just going to go ahead and start with the palette. I'm probably just going to go ahead and whip through this real quick, just come up with a look real quick, and then I will tell you guys my thoughts. I don't know, I don't know, do you guys like seeing, like, the process of me putting eyeshadow on, or do you just prefer I come up with a look and just tell you guys my thoughts? Because I don't know, sometimes I find it kind of boring just to sit there and watch someone blend out eyeshadow, but that could just be me. Let me know down in the comments what you guys think. Alright, so I'm just gonna do this real quick. Okay guys, so I'm just, you know, I know I said I was gonna speed through this, but I don't know, maybe Pierre's stepping up their game, because this is really pigmented. Like, dang, girl. Making me eat my words. Maybe Pierre's finally stepping up. I just know that the past few times that I've gotten some of their palettes, they're just not really been that great. But I don't know, this first shadow that I dug into, this photo op right here, this brown here, I didn't even have to put a whole lot. And I mean, look at the pigmentation. Okay, Pure. Okay. Alright, so I finished the eye look, and I have to say, I think Pure Cosmetics has stepped up their game here, because I'm actually really impressed with this palette. So let me tell you what I did. So I went into this shade here, Photo Op, to use as my transition shade. I just kind of did the overall all over the lid. That's the one that I showed you guys. I was like, dang, the pigment's there. The pigmentation is there. And then I went into Insta Worthy over here, kind of this brownish reddish color, and then I again went over everything, just kind of adding a little reddish to it. And then there's actually one shade in here, there's only actually one shade in here that I don't like. I mean, I haven't tried all of them. There's one that I was just like, this one's not working for me, and that is this VIP Pass shade over here. And only because it's just, there's a lot of fallout whenever I applied it to the lid. It's like a shimmer here, which I was really disappointed in. I mean, let me show it to you guys. I realize I didn't swatch anything. Here it is on the finger. It looks like a nice shade, but I don't know. Maybe I just need to be more careful with it. It's just, when I tried to apply it to my lid, just using my fingertip, it was just falling out, and it wasn't staying. So maybe I need to use a primer or something with this one, but this one was just not really working for me. Or maybe I need to use it all over the lid, because I was trying to like use it to deepen up the corners here, but I feel like it just kind of faded away. It didn't really stick. The shimmer stuck. I mean, I have shimmers over here in the corner, but the actual deep shade did not stay. It was a little disappointing, but that was only just one shade. And then I use this blue here called Electric, and this shade is gorgeous over here. That's what I have mostly on like half of my lid here, is this Electric. It's very pretty. Let me swatch that one for you too. And the shimmers are actually very pigmented, along with the matte shadows. Alright, so there it is. Let me swatch it. It's a very pretty blue shade here. Alright, and then the one that surprised me the most was the Utopia shade here. I put that one in the inner corners here. And at first I thought it was just another light blue, but it's kind of got like a greenish hue to it and gold. It's just very pretty. Let me swatch it. And I think it's kind of got like, it looks a little chunky, but I think it might just have like maybe chunk, like flakes of something, like glitter or something in it. I don't know. It's very gorgeous. A very unique shade there. I can't say I have anything like that. So that one right there. So So that one right there really impressed me. But those are the shades that I used to create this look here. And I actually really like how the look turned out. I was a little iffy, like I said in the beginning, but after working with them and things, I actually really like this palette now. So Pure Cosmetics making me eat my own words here. And like I said, I really think they have stepped up their game because I don't remember the past palettes that I've gotten in BoxyCharms from them being this good. So I'm excited to continue to use this. And I think this is going to be a good add to my collection. Alright, so last product I'm going to be trying out is the Hank and Henry Satin Matte Lipstick here. Oh, I forgot to mention, I did use this when I was doing my eyeshadow look here, and it is nice and it's convenient to use, but I don't know, it worked, but I just don't really see anything special about this. I mean, whenever I do eyeshadow looks and I need to use the same brush and just, you know, get rid of the shadow, I just usually, you know, brush it off on the back of my hand, and that works just as well. I mean, I didn't think that this cleaned my brushes like spectacularly. I mean, it's good and I'll continue to use it. I just don't think I would have gone out and bought it myself. I mean, it's not cleaning them the best. It's getting rid of the shadow. I mean, it's just nothing special in my opinion. But I think it is an interesting product to get in the box, and I'll continue using it. I just don't see the difference between that and just, you know, brushing it off on the back of my hand. Alright, so I'm going to apply the lipstick now, and then I will tell you guys my final thoughts. Alright, there's the lipstick on. I really don't know what is the point of the shimmer on the outside. Because it doesn't actually, like, get on the lips. I think it's just for looks, because the shimmer is not showing up on, because the shimmer is not showing up on the lipstick at all. It's just the matte. You know, it's just a round lipstick, so I guess it's just mostly for looks. But I mean, it is a nice lipstick. It's not my favorite shade. I don't know, shades like this, they're okay. Maybe just not with this eye look, I don't know. Kind of feel like it makes me look maybe a little sickly, I don't know. It's not my go-to shade, but it's not bad. And the formula feels nice. So, I mean, it's a good lipstick. I just, maybe if I had gotten a different shade, but again, I'm just being picky. But I mean, like, again, I just don't understand the sparkles. I guess it's just for looks, because it doesn't, the sparkles don't, they don't apply on your lips. But yeah, it's a good lipstick, and I like Hank and Henry. I'm glad to try it out. That's really just all I have to say about it. All right, so my overall thoughts, I think this month's box was a lot better in the past boxes. I do really like everything that I got. You know, I liked the color switch thing is not something I would per se go out and buy on my own, but I mean, now that I have it, I'm going to use it. And again, like I said, I actually am blown away kind of by this palette. I didn't think I was gonna like it, and I was really disappointed when I saw that it was in my box, but now that I've tried it out and everything, I do like it a lot. Lipstick is good. I mean, I think I will like this shade. I think it's going to grow on me. Like I said, I think it's more of a fall shade. So maybe right now I'm kind of more into summer mode right now. So I'm just like, this shade's not really for me. But in the fall, I may love it. So I am glad to have gotten this. I always like getting things from Hourglass just because I get to try them out and I don't have to pay full price for them. So that's a bonus. That's a good one for me. And then, I mean, I don't mind getting skincare. I'm glad it was only one skincare product. If it had been more than one, I probably wouldn't have been happy. But, you know, I do like getting vitamin C products and trying out different brands. So overall, I am really happy with this month's box. Alrighty guys, that is going to do it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you like seeing these types of videos. And also don't forget to hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss out on any of my future videos. But yeah, let me know down in the comments what you guys thought. What if you guys get Boxycharm boxes, what did you guys think of your box? Did we get the same box or did you get something different? Let me know down in the comments. My premium box should be getting here any day now, so that'll probably be one of the future videos will be of my premium box. I'm excited to see what I am getting in that one as well. But yeah, I hope you guys have a wonderful day and a wonderful week, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Bye!